Okay, folks, the unmistakable sound of the best instrument ever made is the Keech. This is the Model A, and that sound is attributed to the fact that it has an internal drum. This drum goes behind this resonator, is inside here. And see that line round there? Well, that is the back here, which is tightened up by these six chrome screws that presses on the resonator and presses against there, which increases the tension and changes the sound. And you can also got internal nuts there, which you can also increase the tension by pulling down on the skin. This model is, they call it a banjolele, because this was a name patented by Alvin Keech. So on the headstock here you have banjolele, banjo here. Down here you have a serial number, which I can tell from that this model was made in 1923, which makes it about 90 years old. Hope I look as good as this when I'm 90. And on the back here it's got the another number, which has got the A, which tells you it's a Model A. And on the back here, you can't see it, but scratched on the back is the word A, Alvin Keech, as he sort of made this. What I did to this model, I put new friction, adjustable friction tuners on, and put little fibre washers so they hold the tuning and are nice and smooth. And also I put on this, I put on a Gibson type tailpiece. Can you see that here? The Gibson type tailpiece is really good because not only is it easy to put the strings on, you just tie a knot in the end of the string and clip it under here, but also this bit here prevents your wrist or your arm here rubbing on the knots of the strings. Here is a sort of normal Keech tailpiece. There you see, and on there the knots can sometimes rub on your arm. So it's got a really nice tailpiece, you'll like that. But for those of you who want to stick to the original, I have it here, so I'll throw this in with it, this tailpiece. So if you want, you can put it back on again, it's just a couple of screws, really easy. The two most important things with a banjo uke is the tuners or the tuning, because they have to be properly in tune for it to sound right. And the other thing is the action. That's the height of the string above the neck, and this is all adjusted so you can do the nice George Formby strumming if you want. I've got a bridge here, three-legged ebony bridge, but I'll supply also a larger bridge if you want to sort it to be higher. Basically, the lower the action, the easier it is to strum, but the quieter it becomes. The higher it is, the louder it sort of becomes. It comes in a really nice case, original case. That's what they call a fake crocodile or fake snakeskin case. It's in nice condition. It's nice to have the original case. Just dropped something over. Anyway, so I've done everything on this, sorted it all out. Cosmetically, it is nice, but you've got to remember it is 90 years old nearly. So it's got a few scratches and scuff marks. And the drum is not completely central. But all that adds to the character. Rather than rub it down and make it all look new, I'd rather have it as original as possible. This will last for years and years, but it's got that really nice antique-y look. Nothing else.